So, Bernard and I visited this station a little while ago, and I was absolutely appalled. Why do we have to negotiate ramps? I mean, is this a new way of getting out of lifts? As in getting, not having lifts? It can't be. I mean, we've seen online where the ramps here at the station have been slippy due to wintry ice. I mean, that's bound to happen. It's not suitable to have a ramp only a station.
We're here today out in Pellistown train station, the first train station since 2008 that was built by the state, and the reason we're out here today is we're putting on a protest in relation to the issues around access and the fact that it's an all-ramped station, which people mightn't be aware, but with a station that's all ramps, the actual the pressure that's on people with disabilities to be independent is even greater. And if we're honest, all ramps mean you can't really be independent because you need someone with you. And as was highlighted last week, due to the very cold weather, an able-bodied person tweeted to Irish Rail that they felt very unsafe on the ramps. And that was somebody with no mobility issues. So imagine if you were a wheelchair user or someone with impaired mobility due to your age or due to an illness, this station just doesn't fit for you. It's not, you're not included in this station and you're not welcome here. No. What do you think of yourself?
Especially like the soapiness. If it's raining, it's a health and safety hazard. So like if an able-bodied person says that it's harder for them, and that's what a person with mobility issues would think.
I think so. But even Sean, to get across, it took him nearly 17 minutes from the start here to get over there, and he was exhausted at the end of it. So do you think, would you be able to do it?
Getting out of the station is actually longer than the journey to the station.
So, yeah, and there's proposals for future train stations, which are supposed to be public, funded by the taxpayer, and to be inclusive and accessible. There's proposals there to make them all ramped stations, and excluding putting in lifts and other mechanisms with which people with disabilities and mobility impairments could access the trains and public transport. So this station makes us feel
miserable.
When we visited this station a while ago, Bernard videoed me going up and down, up and around the station. And for those who would like to see for themselves, the challenge, it is a time-lapse video, because trust me, the video would take 10 minutes. If you would like to see the video, you can go onto our Twitter page, @accessforall7.
So, Tom Clonan is my name. I'm a carer, parent to a young man with a disability. And today is the International Day of People Living with Disabilities. And I would say disability is not a noun. Disabled is not a noun, it's a verb. So people like my son have been disabled by the state and by society for failing to vindicate their fundamental human rights to a meaningful, happy, fulfilled life. Ireland is one of the worst countries in the European Union to have a disability on every measurement. Social isolation, poverty, homelessness, suboptimal outcomes. We can do better than that. For shame, we should be the best country in the EU for equality, for diversity, and for our wonderful community of people who have been disabled by the state. Thank you.
You'll find the campaign on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You'll have @accessforall7 on Twitter, @access_4_all_Ireland on Instagram, and Facebook Access for All Ireland. And we're prolific on social media. We post every day religiously. We try to bring awareness around the whole issues of disability.